And for doing this, I have a special guest, my preferred guinea pig. Yeah, she is gonna be the one to help me. What is that?
I found it.
Yeah, no, come on, put it back. Put it back. Okay. We don't have always a big studio where we can photograph a model for a catalog shot. Sometimes the client, even the client, can have a small place where you gotta find out a way to photograph. So in this video, pretending to photograph a model for a catalog shot in a small tight place and see what's the challenge, and sharing with you two different lighting technique, and maybe you can get some cool idea also, as always with my video. So first thing, what I'm doing, okay, creating two lights to lit the background, because we are going for with the white background, totally whitening. So in this case, we may need two light. Not sure if the second one is gonna work very well because the space is very limited. So usually this light is better to stay a little bit away from the background, but we'll figure it out. So main light, I'm gonna use my wonderful deep umbrella, the silver one that I like. I like because it gives you a pop, silver, awesome light. And because we don't have much room, I'm gonna put it here. I'm gonna try this. Putting exactly, Carmen is gonna be there, and this flash is gonna be, so the umbrella going there, from kind of the top. And then I'm gonna have one on the side, just to lit more the products. The main problem for when you don't have much room to avoid the light is going to bounce everywhere. The thing is important, high ceiling for example, and maybe the walls, especially if they are white, kind of far away, because otherwise light bounces everywhere. And even the light here from the back, it's kind of close. You see, it's like very close, and problem is gonna be even close to her. So the things can be that if you too much light from the background is gonna be overwrapping her, and probably it's gonna blur the edge of her shoulder. So these are the things that we gotta figure it out little by little. Silver umbrella, and it's gonna be exactly like this, okay? Okay, we'll figure it out with this. Especially when you photograph in a small place, you gotta rely then in Photoshop for sure. I'm gonna whiter the background more, and we're gonna create, we don't have the swipe white background, so I'm gonna create then the swipe in Photoshop. The thing is that if this guy is too close, the cone of light doesn't have enough room to open up and brighten everything, you know? So it's closed, so basically it's like open, it goes like that, and then boom, this is the light. I'm gonna put this guy, I'm gonna flip it, I'm gonna put a umbrella, so at least the light from here is gonna be a little bit more spread out. When I'm in a studio, usually I like bouncing the flash against a V-flat with the open white inside. So it bounces, spread out, and then goes back to the background and make everything much easier and whiter. Okay, we messed up a little bit with the light. So first setup that I'm doing is, so I'm using these two white boards just to create enough room for as a background. The board is gonna be lit from this bare strobe, because as you can see, we don't have enough room, so I don't have room to put an umbrella. So we get this spot here. And then we got the other one. In this side, I have more room, so I'm gonna use an umbrella so that
it doesn't create much hot spot. It's going to spread out a little bit even, and that is going to be the setup for my background. My place where I'm going to sit is going to be where the chair here. We're going to have a main light on top, the silver parabolic umbrella, and with this C-stand so that I don't have any obstacle interfering me. And this is going to be the main one, and then I'm going to have a side light just to fill from one side. On this side of the model I'm gonna have a white board. In this moment, do not pay attention of this spotlight. These are the normal light from the showroom, but consider that I'm gonna photograph at 106 of a second and f11, so f11 more or less we don't gonna get this light into it.
Hold on.
Nice. Oh, that's nice. I look away a little bit. Well, actually, not bad. I mean, the background is bright enough. It's not super bright that overlap even Carmen, actually. So it's kind of white enough to be then Photoshop and put it totally bright white final. The problem can be the bottom part, of course, along the legs and the feet. It's not very well lit because there was a table, but this is something that maybe I can brighten up in Lightroom, for example. And of course, we gotta work on Photoshop because we have to create the seamless. That's nice. Look away, more like side, even with the face facing me.
In this picture, you can see that the main light comes from the top of me, basically straight face Carmen. You see her face is all lit, and we only have sometimes the shadow below the nose when she chin down a little bit.
Try now to use the blue background, but considering, yeah, the space is so small, so what happened is as you can see, the color of the background is totally washed out. So the option in this case is going with this only the main light, and I just shut it off the sides so that the background gets a little bit more the color that it's supposed to be. And then in this case you're gonna get this one. You can see the shadow of hair, of course. But I mean, extending then the border on the side then gets a little bit his job. Usually when I do this stuff, okay, what you gotta do is you gotta lit, rather than thinking with the white background that can be overexposed. In this case, the background has to be exposed properly, otherwise it doesn't show up the real color. And in this mess, I mean, with this small space, the option that you can do is using the main light to lit the background, which is like I did in this picture, for example, years ago. Here you can see the background is more uniform. And basically this was just lit with a main big umbrella behind my back, crank up as max as I could, so this was supposed to give all the general light, and then my lovely silver umbrella on the left side of the camera. And that's the way I achieve this color. Just to give a different feeling. So basically I'm switching, now I have the main light coming from the right side of the camera, and the central one is just giving a general feel. The showroom is huge, but my idea was working on a small tight place, you know, with this table and the wall on the side. Sometimes you can't put much light in a proper way, you know, you gotta work it out, you know. So this is a wrap. We finish everything, we just pack everything. It was
it was a challenge today.
Because shooting in a small place it's always, yeah, I feel like more challenging because you gotta move on this little space and then put the light like that. Sometimes it doesn't work. You gotta do extra there, going on around the table. It's a little tough. But I feel like we got a feeling of what was our goal, to show what does it mean shooting in a real small.
Yeah, and making the best of a situation.
Yeah, right. Wait, subscribe as always, and if you like, put a like, and you know what you do to sustain us.
Bye.
Bye.